proud about the National Health Service. It's a piece of real socialism. It's a piece of real Christianity, too. We had to wait a long time for it. What I had in mind when we organized the National Health Service in 1946 to 1958, and remember when we did it, you know, you younger ones, this is immediately after the end of the Second World War, when we were asked, Sir Winston Churchill then said, a bankrupt nation. But nevertheless, we did these things. And there is nowhere in any nation in the world, communist or capitalist, any health service to compare with it. Now, the National Health Service had two main principles underlining it. One, that the medical arts and science and the healing should be made available to people when they needed them, irrespective of whether they could afford to pay for them or not. That was the first principle. The second was that this should be done not at the expense of the poorer members of the community, but of the well-to-do. In short, I refuse to accept the insurance principle. I refuse to accept the principle that the National Health Service should be paid by contributions. I refuse to accept that. I refuse to accept it because I thought it was nonsense. If you hadn't fully paid up, you couldn't have a second-class operation because your card wasn't full of stamps, could you?